saying welcome back to weekend vlog number 3.
The plan for this week is get the flooring done and fit the fan. So I'll just show you around where we are at so far. So last week we glued the battens down, and this week we're going to finish the insulation. I checked all the battens because we were a bit worried about gluing everything down, but everything is rock solid, even the ones that we were worried about. I tried tugging and pulling on all of them, but they are rock solid. If you remember, we put the ply on top at the end of last week just to weigh everything down, and some of it actually stuck to the little bit of glue that was left on the top. And when we were picking it up, as you can see, the ply actually split. You can see here where it tore a piece down. We'll put it on the bottom anyway, but yeah, I don't think we need nails. It's the whole thing is rock solid. It's like a big glue sandwich, so that's all good. Cass is cutting out the rest of the insulation, and then we'll be cutting the ply floorboards to go down. Here is the workshop situation. We got one of these because, and also one of these guys because it's easier to cut straight lines when we cut the ply with that. What I'm doing now in preparation for the fan is I'm cutting some of these pieces to go in between the roof ridges, and it's actually different on the top than the bottom. On the bottom where you put the wood supports to screw the fan to is this longer piece, and then this shorter piece is the one that we'll put on the top between the roof ridges, you'll see. But it's quite interesting because I thought they were the same size, but they aren't. So I'm gonna cut a few more of these and then I'll show you how that's all going. All right, so here's the situation. Cut three of these now. I'm getting a hang of how to use this thing and the meter saw and circular saw. It's the first time I'm using one of these, so I'm still figuring out how things work. But basically, I cut these strips out of 6mm MDF, and this length or this width matches the width of one of these planks. Which is what we're going to make the frame on the inside. Then once you cut the strips, I made a stopper, which is the exact right length. And then this is at 45 degrees and you just chop like this. Well, actually, once you basically need to turn this wood over every time so it's the right angle. So you chop that, you get one of these, and then you get this edge and you turn it over, so you basically end up with these little blockers, and then this is gonna sit on top, like three of them, like so, and it's gonna fit in perfectly to the ridges of the van like this. So instead of just having a flat wood sitting all the way across, you'll have these for extra support so when you screw the fan in. Right, so here's the contraption. Here's the little spaces I made. And we need three of them per kind of horizontal. So we're just gonna do a test fit.
We'll go here.
And then there will be another one that goes along wherever. And then for these bits, we don't need any. So you need, three kind of spaces. You need six total. So six on the bottom and then six for the top as well. So let's glue all this together and see how it goes. All right, so here's the situation with the floor insulation. We're now gonna have lunch. Cass cut everything out nicely and everything fits perfectly. We just need to start taping the wood up and all the crevices up with foil tape. So that's the plan after lunch. And then on my end, I'm now gluing the frame for the fan. So hopefully that will set over lunch. Cut out all the little spaces for the top of the fan and the bottom of the fan. At the bottom, they'll sit like that. So I'll need to glue that as well after lunch, but I haven't figured out the spacing yet. And I want to set this Cure first.
So. Right, so we haven't got a ladder, but we got a bin. I've seen people do this before, and we don't want to buy a ladder because they're quite expensive, and we're probably going to have a ladder on the back or the side, but we haven't decided which one yet. I wouldn't recommend, but this is how you get up if you don't have a ladder but you have a bin.
You want me to hold it?
Yeah, for health and safety reasons, you can have an extra person.
Yeah.
And now we're going to measure where the fan goes.
Hello, so Laz is currently up on the roof. Literally just finished taping down with aluminium insulation tape all of the insulation that I filled out. The hardest pieces were around the wheel latches, which is obvious, and we have had a few little gaps at the front. So what I'd been using to start with was this thickness tape. I think this was like 3.8, which is the original battens we were going to use. But then we actually changed for 50mm batten, so 55cm. Yeah. So I ended up getting this thickness, but I didn't want to waste the other one. And this one is obviously way easier. I still did have to do two strips, because I felt like it needed it in some places, a double thickness, especially at the other end. I'll leave both of them down below. They weren't too expensive. I think they're like £7 or £8 from Amazon. And we'll obviously use it for when we start to do the walls, which should hopefully be in the next couple of weeks. All done at the moment. We've got a couple of bare bits just at the door where we just need to chisel out a bit of wood where it's lifting slightly, which is why you might not be able to see, but there's a blue beam here and here. So we're gonna do that tomorrow or Monday, and then it will be done. So we've got the ply ready here, ready to go.
I already told them that.
Oh.
Hello.
Well, I didn't hear you say that.
That's
so.
Very
rude. Right. But yeah, Laz is on the roof doing the fan, and I'm going to start the templates, I think, if he doesn't need my help. He might need my help by the look of that face.
Yeah, probably. I need the fan.
Okay, bye.
Right, so I'm up on top of the roof. I just cleaned this bit. This marker here is one rib,
and that marker there is the front rib. This is where you normally put the fan, on this little ledge. You can see how dirty it was. I cleaned everything out, and now we're gonna measure out the middle bit between the two ribs where we wanna put the fan. It's 40 by 40. I drew with a little pencil line. It's getting pretty dark, and the weather doesn't look good. It's not raining yet. So what I'm gonna do now, and double check these measurements from the inside, and then we'll decide if we're gonna do this tonight. We only have about an hour daytime, so it's probably pretty risky, so you might just double check the measuring again and again, and then cut this tomorrow so we're not under pressure.
Good evening. What's the situation?
Our instincts were saying don't do the fan, and good job we didn't, because we then put the template that Laz had made up and it was off centre.
Yeah.
So where Laz had drawn the line on the top, this then didn't fit underneath. So thankfully the glue hasn't fully set. It's almost done.
Yeah.
Because I did have to shove this underneath to get it off, but...
Anyway, I'm going to have to take them off.
And then just move them like here.
And move them over, and instead of having them here, I need a long piece over here.
Yeah.
I mean, this works, but it just means that if you imagine this is the middle of the van, the middle rib, anyway, there's a rib in the middle that's like this. So it would sit like this, off center. Which is a problem because on the top I drew this exactly in the middle.
But yeah, I'm gonna be stripping this all out. I got the winter hat on, got the winter coat on, it's getting cold.
I'm gonna, while Laz faffs around with this, He had a bit of a fanny in the back.
A little bit of a fanny.
I'm going to be starting to do the templates.
Oh my life. Anyway, good job of doing Star Count Home.
Yeah, we've got a 3-day weekend this week.
Yeah, good job of doing Star Rushing into this.
It's my birthday on Monday.
Perfect girl.
Yeah.
Right, well, I'm going to crack over this goddamn frame. The good news is the other bits that I made fit in the top, or we should be fine.
Fit really nicely. So just get these off now, and then you're sorted. You just need that two long bits.
All right. We're going to crack on with this.
So, Catherine. Good morning. We are set for another busy day today. I think we're going to get the fan fitted. Laz is currently still indoors having a shower. He's backwards in showers in the morning, rather than the evening. While he's getting ready, I'm going to start the templates. I did start last night, just cutting them out with cardboard to start with, because we've got absolute heaps from all the deliveries we've been having. So I've done the wheel arches, so what I think I'm going to do is transfer that onto some ply that we've got, which we ripped out of the van to start with this morning, to see if that fits. Then I know this method works, and then we can do all the other little fiddly bits. Until Mr. Laszlo needs my help doing the fan.
Right, so Cass already started a vlog while I was in the shower. Since then, I made some preparations for the fan. We put this out, so to catch all the metal bits, it's just a makeshift bin bag, really. And also, I'm not sure if you can see, but I cut a hole with a tiny drill bit in the middle of my measurements from the top. And then we measured from the inside as well, just to make sure the fan goes in the right place. And now I'm gonna go up to the top, drill the whole corners, and then cut with a jigsaw, and hopefully it's in the right place. Now, I'm not sure what we explained it yet, but the reason why we're putting the fan here and not here, where you have less ridges, is because we're planning on having the shower there, and we're planning to have the kitchen here. So in our head, it makes more sense to have the fan there instead of right at the front. Yeah, that's why we're putting it here, and let's go cut the hole.
So here Laz is just masking taping up the bottom of the jigsaw, so when he starts cutting the top of the van, it doesn't scratch off any of the paint or any of the metal on the top. We've seen loads of people recommend doing this. We didn't actually have any issues after we've cut it, so I highly recommend doing it just to protect your van.
That thing is super loud, so I'm just... We haven't got any ear protectors, so I'm asking Cass to bring me some headphones that I can put on, and then hopefully it won't be so loud.
Cut it slightly too tight, so I had to file some sort like a millimeter away on the side, which took a while, but yeah, everything fits and the hole is not too big, so I'd rather cut it a millimeter too tight and then have to file for half an hour than cut it slightly too big. But yeah, that's all done. Now I'm gonna clean
all of this up,
and then yeah, we're ready to fit the fan.
So here, after Laz has finished cutting the hole and filing away all of the edges and sanding it, he's just taken the Hammerite paint that we used for the floor to prevent rust from ever occurring. And it's just to give the metal a nice finish so that it doesn't ever rust over.
It's lunchtime. We finished the hole. I just finished priming it. I'm now going to clean all the way around the edges. The paint should be dry, the primer should be dry. So just going to clean all this up with some window cleaner and just some cloth. Let that dry off, and then we'll be ready to start gluing things down. Alright, so I put the frame on, and then I just put masking tape all the way around so we get a cleaner Sikaflex line once we glue everything in. And now I'm gonna start gluing these pieces
down there first, and then we're gonna glue all the way around the frame at the top and the bottom, drill the holes through and fix the screws in. All right, here we are.
Got everything, got the top, got my little spacers, got the glue, got the screws, got the drill. Cass is down there.
Ready to glue.
Ready to glue the bottom bit. And then we got some clamps that will clamp everything together so Cass doesn't have to keep holding that up while I drill through and screw everything on.
We're just taking it in turns. My forearms hurt. I haven't got quite strong forearms as what I should probably have to do this, but Laz is now just gluing the one on the top, or the frame on the top, so we can sandwich it together. It's got a gap. So after that faff and the frame not actually fitting and having to readjust, which we obviously didn't film because we thought it was going to fit, Laz is now just sick of flexing up the edges and the holes, in which we'll show you a bit later on his finished result.
Alright, bonus day Monday. Whoop, whoop, whoop. Alright, now that Kaz had a drumming session, we're gonna... Today's plan... Well, anyway, yesterday, after all the big faff of the fan install, we managed to get it all fitted and it looks nice and neat. I will show you that in a bit. But today's plan is to finish templating and cut the floor ply. So that's the main goal for today. And then we'll probably just do some tidying up and stuff like that. So yeah, hopefully we managed to fit the floor because it's pretty annoying getting the ply in and out of the van.
Every morning.
Every morning. And so wish us luck and let's crack on. Whoop.
All right, so here's the roof fan. Show you the finish. I think it's a pretty neat job. The little stoppers is at the bottom work perfectly. And the masking tape, so hopefully this will work. Cass will lower the fan so we can show you what that looks like as well. So it looks like that when it's lowered all the way down. Yeah, it's all ready to go. Alright, so here's the situation on the inside. After we faffed around with the frame, we made new spacers and repositioned them. And it looks pretty good. These extra spacers really help give extra support. The only gap we have is this tiny bit, which is nothing major structurally. So yeah, it looks pretty good. And then the bottom frame will slot in like that. It will look really nice and neat, and the roof will, depending on how low we put the roof, it should be in line exactly with this. Pull it down a bit, and we can always trim a bit of the plastic, as says in the instruction. Depending on how low you want this frame to go, you just trim a bit of the plastic off, and it's going to give us a really nice, neat job. Happy days. And meanwhile, Cass has been working on the framing. We got this first. We're basically using the old side panels that we took off from the sides. It's like really thin wood. So Cass is making the templates out of this. And she's finally got the first one to fit. And that middle one that she cut in half because it was a bit too long. But yeah, we should be able to transfer that over. And then now we just need to make a... Well, that's a simple template. It's just going to be a
fly with a bit of it cut short. And yeah, so we're gonna crack on with templating and then cutting the main ply sheets, and hopefully we'll have the floor finished today. Right, so first circular saw major cut. It's not the easiest thing. I thought it was going to be a lot easier to cut a straight line with that thing. But you still have a bit of wiggle room, really, to not cut a completely straight line. What?
We should have clamped a straight bit of wood here. So you didn't.
Oh, yeah. Big brain. All right, we're going to do that next time. But anyway, yeah, if you're thinking about freehanding a circular saw like I did...
Don't. So quick update, we've done our first ply floor board. From the template, we've got it into the little nooks and crannies here and at the other side as well. Which is, that one was a little bit harder.
Yeah, we
so
had to cut an extra one, but it's all good.
From the mistake from the cutting, we've put it against here, and that bit is actually going to be covered anyway, so it's not an issue. This bit is the straight line, which is obviously the more noticeable bit, because that's where we're going to be coming in and out. We are going to put a metal lip across that, but...
So it's nice and protected.
We're gonna have lunch and then we're gonna do the other ones. This one should be relatively easy because it's straight both ends. We just got to cut off a big bit from the other end, and then the next bit is obviously the more tricky bit.
This is the Mission Impossible.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's coming together. It looks really nice.
Yeah.
And
so
for these bits where we torn up, we actually done goof, because if we flip the board around when we cut those bits, then this would be underneath, but we realized it's too late. So what we're gonna do, you probably wouldn't see it anyway once we, or feel it once we put the vinyl on top, but before we do that, we're gonna sand these bits down, and we're gonna use a wood filler to fill this bit up, and then sand it all down so it's nice and smooth, just to make sure that it's done properly. But yeah, it's all good, so we're gonna crack on with the next ones.
And just like that, another week is over. So we finished the floor and the fan this week, which is really exciting. Slowly starting to see the van come together, and now we don't have to tippy toe around the insulation. Next week, Laz tackles the side trims, which have had plastic bags over for the past week. So the clips finally came and he cracks on with that. And we block out the layout, which is super exciting and feels a little bit more real. So see you next week, guys.
All right, bonus.
Bonus.
We're gonna beep that because that was too.
But yeah, so we're gonna have lunch.